the gospel of the Lord.
My dear brothers and sisters, we celebrate the beginning of the Paschal Triduum, and today is the Maundy, or Holy Thursday. We call it Maundy. Thursday comes from the Latin mandatum, which means command. And the very command of our Lord Jesus is to love one another. And here, we celebrate tonight's liturgy, two important sacraments among seven sacraments. And this is the sacrament of the Eucharist and the sacrament of the Holy Priesthood. And as we celebrate and reenact and remember these two sacraments, leading us to the very meaning of Christian service, in which our Lord Jesus Christ Himself gave us an example, the service which is out of humility, a selfless giving of Himself. And that is the Holy Eucharist that we celebrate tonight. And also tonight, we shall have the reenactment of the washing of the disciples' feet. And we have heard in our gospel reading today that our Lord Jesus Christ saying, "Do you realize what I have done for you? I have given you a model to follow so that as I have done for you, you should also do." The most beautiful liturgies of the church happen actually on Paschal Triduum. These are the holiest days. That's why these are the three important days that we have to celebrate: the Holy Thursday, the Good Friday, and the Easter Vigil. And tonight we have the Holy Thursday liturgy. And we're gathered once again as one community to reflect to the very meaning of Christian service that our Lord Jesus Christ is trying to remind us every now and then. Christian service is the very mark of the very love of Christ to us. We are being reminded always, for we fail to forget always the very meaning of Christian service. Our mind is limited because what we understand is only is the service that our mind can comprehend. A service that is calculated. A service that is self-serving. A service that doesn't go beyond extra mile. A service that is not selfless but selfish. And tonight we are once again reminded of this very meaning of Christian service that we should give to one another. The washing of disciples' feet is a strong symbol and sign. Jesus washed the disciples' feet for us to remind that we can wash each other's feet. It is the very humble act to wash others' feet, because we know if there is one or a part of the human body that can be considered one of the dirtiest part of the human body is the foot or the feet. But then this is a reminder for us that our Lord Jesus Christ reminding us that we can serve selflessly to one another. we can wash each other's feet. And that is, this is the very meaning of our Christian call as baptized member of the body of our Lord Jesus Christ. My dear brothers and sisters, the two sacraments that we celebrate tonight, which are the Eucharist and the institution of priesthood, are in fact continuously bringing us back the connection of the community and our role as to your priests in the community. In fact, if we have to follow our liturgy, the Chrism Mass takes place this morning, which is giving us the very meaning of the priesthood of our Lord Jesus, in which it reminds us also that we share to the priesthood of Jesus, and that we see that we embrace the sacrament by our act of humble service to one another. And oftentimes we know that we fail due to human propensities. But we are being reminded once again, my dear brothers and sisters, that our Lord Jesus Christ, by the very act of washing each other, the disciples' feet, reminding us that we can also do the same. And we can also render a selfless service, a loving service, and a humble and true service to one another. My dear brothers and sisters, we are commanded to love one another, not only in words, but in actions, and most especially in showing love for each other. Sometimes our love is a love that is not rooted to the very love of our Lord Jesus to us. As I have said, our love is calculated. Our love is measured. Our love is limited. But tonight, we're once again reminded that our love can be beyond measure. Our love can be selfless. Our love is not being measured. And my dear brothers and sisters, as we continue to celebrate this Eucharist, and most especially this service, as we witness the reenactment of the washing of the disciples' feet, may we also be reminded to wash each other's feet. My dear brothers and sisters, may our love for one another is true, and that is beyond measure and selfless giving of ourselves. We continue to love each other. We continue to show our care for each other. For our Lord Jesus Christ has loved us first. For our Lord Jesus Christ has served us first. That is why, let us serve and love one another. My dear brothers and sisters, our Lord Jesus Christ gave us a commandment to live every day, and that is to love one another. When he said, love one another, he's saying, serve one another. When he said, serve one another, let us serve in the humility, in selfless giving of ourselves. Amen.